IVM.
कृपया ध्यान दीजिए, the language used on the podcast may not be fit for consumption. We warn you, tread carefully. But listen yaar, don't be so conservative. Hello and welcome to our show. Let me show my excited face. Yes, it's called Cyrus Says. My dad insisted we name it that. He was the sponsor initially. It was only 16 rupees to broadcast. So you divide it per day Wi-Fi that you pay over the year. Now it's a little more. And today we have a lovely guest, a talented guest from a very talented family. So she's going to bring a lot of fun to the show. And it's going to be interesting to see her journey. And of course, I'll ask her silly questions and irritate her and upset her. And she'll walk out in anger and spit on me. That's the aim of the show. But before we do that, some good news that I've just got. The cheetah. The animal is going to be brought back into India. It was extinct about 70, 80 years ago. Let's not start why and how. But now they're going to do a program to bring them back and rebreed them in a sense in their old environment, which is very much here in India as well as Africa. So that's great. So we're going to get the cheetah back. Now if we can get human beings back, I think everybody will be very happy. By human beings, I mean people in Malabar Hill and Little Gibbs Road who live next to me. I want those human beings to come back from the shells they are right now of fear, anxiety, shame, depression, and always negative thought and feeling. So my thought is, with the cheetah, let's hope there's a breath of fresh air and humanity returns as well.
From uncensored and unfiltered chats with the who's who of the entertainment industry, I, Siddharth Kannan, bring your very heartcake chat show called Candid Kannan. Tune in every Friday on the IVM podcast app or wherever you get your podcasts.
In the meantime, to more cheerful things, let's talk to my batchmate from St. Xavier's College, Shreya Pilgaonkar, from the famous Pilgaonkar family. And which is a lovely painting. Good morning. Shreya, what a lovely painting behind you of, I presume, cheetahs.
Oh, the cheetahs, like you mentioned, they're going to be brought in, right? So I think we're going to have to paint one.
Wow. Yeah. Superb. Yeah, you're on the ball today. I'm going to be in trouble. So we have to start at the beginning of Xavierite. I was just going to the biodata. And I always think maybe not go there because of age and all that. And then I realized that you passed out in 1989. Am I right?
No, I was born in 1989.
Oh, sorry, you were born in 1989? No. One sec. The old man's not taking his medication, which is here somewhere. So you passed out in many years later. I passed out in 1993. So my point is that you were 4 when you passed out. So we probably, you know, may not have met in the halls of St. Xavier's College.
But Cyrus, I have to get this out of the way. Way back in the day, not to make you sound old or anything, I was a fan of MTV Loveline. I used to watch that show.
You've been 10?
Yeah, 10.
It went on till 2006, 2007. Your teen years. It would have been that. I'm doing the maths.
No, younger actually.
99, we started Loveline. That I remember clearly. Because we started Bakra at the same time and both these shows. 99, and so you would have been 10-ish. Should never ask a woman her age, but I Googled it. And it ran for 5-6 years. So 15, 16. So key time to watch a love program, 10 to 15, 16, somewhere there.
Oh, man. And I was so fascinated. Also, you were very invested
athletic.
Athletic also, but I think Malaika was more invested in the advice and you were just trying to ruin the, you know, relationship or the questions because you would always give really bad advice on that show.
Yeah, I had a very noble motive now that you bring it up. We had it was Bombay Labs. Your parents will remember this place because it goes back to the Mangeshkars and before, very much part of Mumbai folklore, making films and all, and TV shows, etc. etc. So we had this place called Bombay Labs in Prabhadevi, next to Siddhi Vinayak. So, you know, our part of town. So happy to be there. But parking, Shreya, that parking, ask your dad. It had parking. You could park your own car. I would drive my little Maruti and park it without even looking. I remember Shana's coming. Yeah, can you even think of, you know, driving your own car in Mumbai after lockdown? Yeah, so the main point is we used to play cricket and the episodes would just come in between that because we had a big space and the boys and I would just, we had a tennis ball, plenty of that. And so the episodes of Loveline were always coming. We were just trying to finish them fast so we could get back to the game, you know, Deepak Dhar batting 96 and then again episode 2. So quickly finish that, then he can get his 100. Yeah.
I mean, just wanted to say that that was a really fun show and that's when I first saw you. So it's kind of full circle now. Here we are.
And now, 30 years later, you're saying how young and good looking this young man is. But let's not talk about me. Let's talk more about you. I've got so much. First and foremost, I have one slightly contentious question. It's not really contentious, but I'm sure you've heard it all your life. I'm a big supporter of celebrity. No, celebrity is a terrible word. Even famous is a terrible word. Let's say accomplished parents. I think that's a nicer word. Accomplished parents, you know, they leave a certain legacy and there's a little bit of pressure. Oh, for example, remember fighting for young Milind Deora many years ago on an NDTV program because somebody kept asking him, but you came into politics because your dad's a politician. But it's also not his fault, you know, that his dad's a politician. He wasn't like born and said, I choose my dad to be a politician. No, it comes with the territory. So first and foremost, let's get this out of way, the elephant in the room. Did you ever feel pressure being Supriya and Sachin's child and they're working while you were working? It's not even like they had
one. And they still are. Yeah.
And they still are. Yeah. You know, I mean, that shadow is there. So is that good or bad? Is that difficult?
It's never bad. Absolutely. I don't look at it in any negative way at all. And to be honest, the reason why there's genuinely no pressure in that sense, and I'm not using the word pressure, because I feel like that's not how I've been brought up. My parents have not really made me look at life in terms of only trying to compete with other people. I think I've always been someone who is genuinely competing with how I was yesterday. That is how it's been. But a tremendous sense of responsibility always. So for me, more than how I'm known as an actor, etc., what my work ethic is, how I'm with people, you know, how I sort of am taking my ups and downs. That's where I keep in mind that, okay, what have my parents taught me? The legacy that I would like to leave eventually, besides the work that I do, is how I am as a human being, because that's what, you know, that's what reaches my parents. That's what people tell my parents if they've enjoyed working with me. So it is a sense of responsibility, I would say. And yes, I want to make them proud. And I think it's an absolute privilege to be born in a family of artists, really.
I've got a great question listening to you. So rank in ascending order in the Pilgaonkar family, rank the best actor to, well, the third best actor, because there's no bad actor. So let's, how would you rank? And I'll be honest.
I'll be honest.
Mom and Dad will see the show. I want to hear.
No, I'll tell you what we, I mean, only two people. I'm not even involving myself in this.
No, you must.
Because I'm not, so I'm last in this ranking, obviously.
Yeah, so you've gone for the obvious. I will be diplomatic and come third. Okay. First and second is enough controversy.
It's not controversy because my dad and I both agree. We are both fans of my mother as an actor. So mom is one. Second is obviously dad. I'm saying like dad is a star. So he's number one there. And mom is in her acting prowess. No one can even come close to her.
So you're saying talent-wise, mom won. But star, I mean, showmanship and star, and of course, the shows that he hosted, the all those shows make him an icon across India and everywhere. Dad, you're very good. You should have been a lawyer. You're very good. You've kept both the parents happy. If I was the parents, I'd be very happy with this answer.
No, but it's like true. Win-win. It's true. It's true. Genuinely.
But Shia, what about people? There must be people who are jealous. You know, because when you see famous, and you've got two, remember, that's a double thing. Normally, you have one, you know, you go in your father's footstep, your mother's footstep, fine. Now, it's a double whammy, and they're working actors till today. They're competing with you in a sense also. Do you ever find people around you think, oh, it's easy for her? I mean, you know, after all, who's going to say no to, you know, Sachin and Supriya's child and whatever, they know everybody and one phone call and, you know, you get an audition. You're with Aquarius, if I can say correctly.
AK Various.
See, what an old man I've become. But you know what I mean? People might think it's a little easier. But a lot of people ask us at airports and, you know, stations and all, yeah, I want to be a VJ, I want to be an actor. And what do you, you know, we don't know where to start. Let's face it. You have people coming in your house, go in your house. You've attended rehearsals as a young kid. You know all these people. So it is a little easier. So how do you deal with, if anybody says anything, does it upset you?
See, no matter what you do or what your journey is, people are going to think what they want to think. And people really don't know much about your journey. And, you know, with me, Cyrus, what's happened is I feel like a lot of people have sort of seen where I've started from. They were there when my first Marathi film released. They've seen my step-by-step growth. If I had it easy, I would have been on the cover of Vogue after my first film, which was not the case. I did not have
one phone call, Shreya. I would have done it.
But you know what? To be honest with you, maybe, and I don't want to sound cocky, but maybe I truly had faith in my capabilities and I did not want to go down that route because I was also exploring myself as an actor. I did not know that I wanted to act until I was like 22, 23, when I was also sort of, you know, making short films and stuff. So it was a very organic process for me. So no, I never asked my parents to pick up the phone and call anybody. Of course, they know people. Of course, when I've met people, most of them have known. But if it was that easy for me, a lot would have come much sooner. And because I think for me, work brought in work, and people saw that, I don't get that flack, you know, as much. And even I do, luckily, you know, during the whole favorite word, nepotism conversation, when there were one or two people saying things, I had other people speaking on my behalf. I didn't even have to say anything. So for me, I have let my work speak for itself, and I want to be deserving of the opportunities. And whenever possible, my parents, of course, you know, they're there to guide me, and I will take their guidance. But it's not like I was not really, I had my own struggles, whether people want to believe it or not. And I still do, but I own it. Yeah.
Okay, now let me just explain that this is a tribute to you. I'm just getting this out of the way because I like asking these questions because people should know the other side. Okay, I think Sushil Kumar, India's famous wrestler who's now in jail and one of the greatest poets, said that every action has an equal and opposite reaction. You know, so people only look at it from that side, but also the fact that you guys growing up with this on top of your head, there's the pressure that you've got to be as good. But Pilgaonkar name is, you know, yours and you've inherited that. So that also is a different pressure that other people don't see. You know, they only see the point of view that maybe their doors open, but their doors open, but the pressure to deliver is much more than some girl called Rubaina Sharma who's come from Chandigarh and nobody knows who she is and she can try five times and flop five times or whatever. That's also there. So now we won't waste time with all that because I don't want this to be a heavy show. Otherwise, I'll fall asleep. Shreya, let's go straight into your life, which I've written down. I have notes somewhere. And if I can read, because I'm wearing my wife's specs and her bra today for some reason. Don't tell her. But she's wearing nothing. That's lovelier. Sweetie, lost something.
And you're talking to me while she's inside. How lame.
21 years of marriage, boss. It's damn tough. We now use the same razor and everything. That's a story for another day. You're still younger.
Okay. Yeah.
No, look, hey, listen, sexism. Come on. Talk about sex.
Same razor equality is unhygienic. Forget this. Nothing to do with equality. You know, it's unhygienic.
So what we do is we toss, like in cricket, and whoever wins the toss shaves first. So in that sense, it's unhygienic only for the second person.
Wow.
Shall we explore your life?
How many years has it been, Simon?
I have to remember. Give me 2001 to 20 complete. Ramsey Brothers production, 20 saal baad. And this is it. This is where we are.
Congrats to her that she stuck around.
Oh, she's but separate rooms now. She's there somewhere. I'm in the office. We have a small office. Listen, I'm going to run out of time because you're talking more than me. Ekul Di Ek, what is the first one?
Ek is my Marathi film debut.
By the way, there's some like five languages that you do. And it can't be easy. I mean, French, you know, all over the place. We'll come to it. Let's go step by step. So that was Sachin's film. And you were how old? That's the beginning. Let's go straight there first. And you won an award.
I was 23. And in fact, before that, I was doing theatre. Funny part was that my parents had no idea. I'm a complete nerd at heart. So I love studying. And I, you know, at one point I thought, okay, I'll, you know, get into the civil services. I was also making short films, documentaries. I was all over mentally wanting to
Civil explore. Services?
Yeah. Don't ask. I was just like, I had
no really pressure there.
Crazy ambitions, yeah. And then one day a friend said that I'm just doing a 10-minute play. You have to sing, dance and act. Just 10 minutes. Will you come audition? I said, yeah, okay, cool. I mean, I was always comfortable on stage and in front of the camera or whatever. So I said, I'll do it. And I got selected for it. Cyrus, for those 10 minutes, we've rehearsed for 1 month. And every time I've been rehearsing, my mom would come and she would tell my dad, oh my God, I think she wants to act. Oh my God, it's happening. Oh my God, she wants to become an actor. And finally, my mom came to me. She said, listen, don't tell me you want to act now. I said, Mom, I'm exploring. I don't know. And then the funniest thing she said to me, Cyrus, was, you realize you're going to have to like get ready, take care of yourself. You don't do that. You realize that's an important part. Are you ready for it? You're too lazy. I said, you know what? We'll cross the bridge when we get there. And eventually when I did that play, that's when my father saw me perform for the first time as an adult. And in his career, he's known to have sort of given opportunities to several people, including my mother and her first film dad had directed. And that's when he came to me saying that he was anyway working on a father-daughter subject. He said, do you want to do this with me? I said, people are going to completely dragged me down saying, how predictable, father or daughter doing a film. He said, have a read, read it. And don't say no just because you think this is about ego or what people will say. The part is excellent. And I agreed. I said it would be like film school for me. And I did the film. And thankfully, people liked my performance. And I got an award for it eventually. So it worked out well.
And what is, just quickly, daddy directing? Because there's a dynamic at home, which will be whatever it is.
Yeah.
And are you daddy's little girl in that sense? What happens on the set? I mean,
super,
that must be...
No, but super professional, Cyrus, because see, my parents have also worked together so much in Marathi films, Tutu Meme, where he's also directed her. So it comes very naturally to us, you know, and several times, even at home, if we have to film something, it's so fascinating. I really feel like I should have a separate camera on to shoot. Like, they help me sometimes record my auditions. I said, if people see this, they'll be so fascinated to see that Sachin and Supriya...
They direct your auditions, like it, edit it, make sure, wow.
No, no, excellent. Not edit, nay. I would do all that. But in a sense, you know, it's really nice that they're part of this process also. Because at that stage, the way things were done, you know, they were different. And now the process is different. So
but
it
how does
actually
dad,
feels collaborative.
But on the set, he was dad? Like, I wonder if I had to, you know, work with my kids. And I'm a very soft father. So I'm just thinking, on the set, you can't suddenly start shouting after 20 years powering your child.
But what do you think I was doing? I was not doing anything for him to shout at me. In fact, I was very nervous because I felt like if I mess it up, I'm also, it's dad's name at stake as well, not just mine. So that pressure was there at that point for me. But somehow, we were on the same page because he had involved me even in, like, on the script level at the ideation. So we sort of did it together. And even the mistakes we made, there were some things we didn't agree on, but then I had to respect.
Shreya, you go back home and dinner ka baatchit
you don't
exactly
speak about.
But
you don't, you cut off from it, yeah? You cut off.
Oh, that's
from
good.
It.
I was thinking that become too much, you know, 1 month schedule plus or whatever. Din raat ko same, I mean, you talk about that exact day, which must have been hard enough as it is doing one take or doing one shot or whatever.
Yeah.
But who's a better singer? Does he think you're a good singer?
I sing, but dad is an excellent singer. I mean, there's no comparison. I'm a fluke singer. Some songs I sing well, some I don't. Dad sings, like, he's genuinely very, very good. So.
And he can sing anything.
Anything, like, yes.
That generation had to work harder. Yeah, this is my whole thing is that generation, if you didn't have genuine talent, you couldn't do much. You had to really be good.
Cyrus, if you think about it, for example, my father has been working since the age of 5. It's probably his 55th year in the industry.
Exploitation of labor. I will take it up with the Thackeray family right now. Where's my damn phone? Yeah.
But he won a national award also at the age of 5. He won a national award. So just the experience, the life experience, that's like on set is what they've learned, right? That was a schooling. So what I really genuinely value, and I'm sorry to get serious about this, but it's the fact that it strikes me every time, is the way actors, you know, right? We're super vulnerable, emotional, and we take things to heart. But what I've learned from them are these things, you know, when things are not right, how are you looking at these situations? And that's where I feel like that emotional intelligence that I have gained from them, that is priceless more than anything else. And that's the luxury I have.
Okay, tough question. Rank these actors, icons from Marathi stage and movies and Hindi movies in order of best performer. Your dad, Ashok Saraf, Mahesh Manjrekar. And your time starts now.
In term,
not on comedy or anything, everything across the board. See, Ashok and Mahesh may not watch this podcast ever. You'll be
saying. It's not. No. Because for me.
You have to eat dinner at home. Shreya, I'm feeding you these questions.
Okay, Ashok Kaka and Papa are first, and then Mahesh sir is later. I haven't seen Mahesh sir much in his stuff. So
what are you saying?
Yeah.
As an actor, also, so much is there.
Yeah, but it's my personal liking of what I like.
Okay, fair enough. I can't bully the contestant's choice is final. Come, let's get back to your career.
I didn't know I was signing up for a quiz, huh?
I just want to ask silly questions in between. You know, I once went to a Marathi award show many, oh God, you must have been five or something. And your dad was there. All these stalwarts were sitting together and all. And I remember, I think Baman was getting an award or going there. So we all went with him. And they were a little bit out of place because there's a whole community of, you know, achievers. And we were like from, you know, we don't belong in the whole achievers thing. And they put us in the front row, second row next to. And your dad was sitting right there. And then I got up because he came after me and offered the seat to him. I remember he bus. That's all he said to me. Two words, bus with his hand. And so I was very happy. I'm sure he'll never remember that. He must be some fat, strange-looking guy sitting there in a suit. I, of course, was overdressed. I was the only guy in a suit, by the way. Nobody, those are early days. We don't know functions. I've never attended these things. In future, I went in shorts also. But at that time, you know, I don't know. And they were so... And Marathi culture, you know, like everybody, you know, it's almost like obnoxious to overdress. You know what I'm saying? This is suddenly like...
True, but maybe at that particular event.
They all carried off their thing, but nobody was overdressed. I just looked like a caterer or someone from, you know, some other industry who's sitting there.
Caterer wearing a suit, nice.
Yeah, they always have a suit, the caterer.
Yeah.
Let's talk about you. French film. Okay, let's go in order then. So this, obviously, you got an award. Maharashtra, what is it? Where's the thing?
State Government Award.
State Government Award, no less. That's huge. So that must also help your confidence, I would think. First film, State Government Award.
It did. But of course, then I stepped into the big bad world of exploring Hindi films and stuff like that. So the whole rata footitioning, never ending, right? I mean, we still do it. And that sort of started. Kept doing that. Then, you know, you get some things, you don't get some things. And then, like you said, a wonderful French film came my way as a result.
See, I haven't seen it. I should have done my homework and watched everything. But as usual, I'm useless. You have to speak in French.
No, in French. So in that particular film, I didn't have to. I was playing, I mean, trust the French to add extra layers. I was playing an actor, an Indian actor, in a film within the film.
Oh.
Process that. Indian actor in a film within the film.
Famous play within the play that we've all done? God. My mind. Anyway, come back. Yeah. I'll tell you later. And that was shot where?
That was shot in Delhi and in Mumbai, but it was a surreal experience because the main actor of that film was Jean Dujardin, who had just come out of the glory of the film The Artist. You know, he won an Oscar for it.
Yeah, and he may I say his name? Jean Dujardin.
Jean Dujardin.
Sounds like a verb. Jean Dujardin. Yeah. He's running somewhere, you know.
Yeah. Literally. So that film, I mean, even though I had a small part in that film, the team was excellent. And even Claude Lelouch, the director, he's a veteran filmmaker, has made some brilliant films. So it was really, again, another encouraging experience because I've always also wanted to explore doing films internationally. So it gave me a bit of push that maybe perhaps.
Straight from Daddy's production, you went straight from there into an international production where you absolutely know no one and whatever. So that's like a huge jump. You know, where Hindi films, you still know a few people. There'd be like enough common actors and performers and technicians. But here, boom. Then you went to Beecham House. Is that next?
No, or then I did Fan.
Oh, you went Fan. Correct. Yes. Shah Rukh. Tell us about that.
Well, same thing. Auditioning. I was auditioning at YRF. And, you know, several times I wouldn't be told what I'm testing for. And sometimes I would be just called to, you know, test with...
What do they don't tell you what you're testing for? What if it's an erotic film or something? How do you...
I think you can tell if it's going to be erotic.
Yeah, because, the dialogue.
Yeah. There wouldn't be dialogue, I think, if it's erotic. So, I would have
what have you been watching? This French influence has been very bad.
What have you been watching, Cyrus?
20 years of marriage, Baba. Have a heart. Sorry.
So, yeah. I mean... I kept testing for it, not knowing what I've been testing for. And then sometimes I was also called to test with, you know, male actors because they just needed somebody to give them cues. So even though I wasn't on camera, I would just keep practicing. You know, I was
comfortable. But that relaxes you, doesn't it? Doesn't that relax you a lot when you act? Because there's no tension on you and then you actually get better at it.
Exactly.
That's a great way to audition.
Exactly.
Because the focus on the other person and you sort of relax and then your best sort of performance.
So that sort of did end up happening. And then for 6-7 months I was testing and then I got called and I said that I was told that the director had seen a couple of my improvs. And he really liked that. And that's how Fan happened. And
so let's segue here. You were doing improvs on stage somewhere as well.
I wasn't doing improv. I wasn't, but I was doing theater. I was doing theater.
Okay.
I just started. But I was still very new to acting and performing on a regular basis, if that makes sense. I hadn't done enough of it. But these auditions really helped. And I really thank my stars that I had enough auditioning experience, because I think that really gives you some training, or, you know, it just helps you practice your craft over and over again. Yeah, and then fan happened, and that still feels surreal for me.
And you didn't know what was with Shah Rukh and all that. You just did an audition and came out of it.
I had no idea. I had no idea. And when I was told, I was blank. There was blankness. It was like, huh? Okay. Huh? Mom, I just got a film and Shah Rukh is in it. I'm doing it. There's no discussion. Yes.
Nice film, I saw it. Was he nice to you?
You know, everybody who meets Shah Rukh will tell you this. He makes you feel like you're his best friend.
Correct.
Because he treats you, he gives you that love, he gives you that respect. And I clearly remember we were shooting a sequence in a real colony, like in Delhi. And when we were doing that scene, we couldn't hear each other because people were yelling, Shah Rukh, Shah Rukh. So I was had to lip read, ki acha iska dialogue khatam ho gaya, ab meri bari hai. So that, to work with a superstar, not a star, a superstar, a megastar, to see how people are lining up for him, to see how he's calm, focused, dealing with those people. And in all of this, in the break, when we would sit in the car, what is Shah Rukh discussing with me? Books.
Which he's not returned to a Delhi library for 40 years.
You know what he said to me? He said, how many books can you buy? I mean, this Kindle is great. You can highlight. And he was being such a student and a child about it that I was just like, wow. I was trying hard not to like melt.
Oh, they don't understand Indians. Why do we do that? We keep shouting Shah Rukh, Shah Rukh, Shah Rukh. There's no second point. You just call the guy's name.
Yeah.
That's it for half an hour.
Yeah.
I mean, it's not like a conversation. Yeah. There's no second line, third line.
Yeah, there's no second line.
It's Shah Rukh. It's like how the guys used to say.
Like, not even come and have tea or something. Like, just Shah Rukh.
Exactly. I mean, go somewhere with it. But I remember in Xavier's, the guys used to always, the slightly more nervous guys, or less confident, if I can say that, would come and say, can you, I don't know if the line stayed in your time, but they would always say this, can you get me an intro to this girl? This intro to this girl. Yeah, that was a phrase that my generation used a lot. And they always thought, you give the intro, it's like the audition, you passed. And then the girl is going to fall in love with you. And it's got, all you're doing is saying, okay, Vikram, say hi to Renu. I mean, it's literally that. And after which, Renu has no interest in Vikram.
But you know, she's really, huh?
Absolutely. She was just being, you know, formal and polite or whatever. And the other the guy, he's got stars in the sky and he's, you know, say, playing love songs in the car or whatever at home. And it's so sad how many Indian men get fooled just because a girl they like says hello. And this famous intro.
I have sort
the
of
word. Did you guys use the word intro?
We didn't use it, but it feels like I've heard it.
Your guy friends must have said they like a girl, or someone coming up to you and saying he wants an intro. They never use the word.
Intro, not intro, but somehow I'm the one I end up going.
You're an extra. You're an extra. You're the rare Indian girl. But today's generation, of course, much different from mine. But yeah. So you would approach guys?
Not guys, like one guy who I liked, and then he told me, he said, I would have never been able to come and, you know, speak.
This is college?
College.
This is college, or you were famous or before famous?
College, famous and all, what? I started acting.
Famous makes a difference, because then the person's ego gets stoked.
I started acting after college. In college, I was not acting at all. I was fully into Malhar. A Malhar chai person, by the way. Hello.
Wow.
Woo! Just saying.
Yeah.
So I was like, who cares?
I was open house. I don't know if they still had it. We used to do the open house in the quad. So open house was like a quiz where we throw toffees and get people to sit and then performances happen. And
oh, wow. Why didn't we have that?
I don't know. I thought it was still there. So it was a famous part, in the proper quad. So it was called open house, and it's like an informal session all day, but non-stop. And we plan all kinds of things. It's very good opening for being an anchor, because you have to go on and on and on. And we literally, two of us, me and Jayashree, this was
so fascinating. I think that's completely stopped.
I was like a beggar. We used to throw the toffees in, so they sit, na? Indians, you have to bribe. There's no Amitabh Bachchan coming on stage. So who cares about Cyrus Brocha and Jayashree? You know,
I think all of that helped you.
It does. Like, nothing was tougher than college. And college, yeah, I don't know again how they treated you guys, but they would abuse us coming on stage if we were presenting rock bands and all. The South Bombay crowd could be very aggressive, you know, F word and MCBC and all that in chorus. They would sing abuse.
I think they got
the effing music
over a period of time.
Start the effing music, which is go on, and then they start abusing you if it doesn't start.
Oh man, so, that's tough.
I was toughened up. I can take on Haryana. I have no problem. You put me anywhere now. I'm immune to abuse. Yeah.
But you know, but I also knew Ali from Xavier's, who I eventually did Mirzapur with.
Oh, yeah. Okay. There
so
you go.
Ali Xavier's is also Xavier, right?
Decent amount of people who've, over the years, going back to the 70s, I mean, we've given a lot of interesting people.
Absolutely. Yeah. Even Akash, AK Various.
Yeah. Is Xavier right?
Xavier right.
There you go.
Yeah.
Wow. Okay, let's quickly talk about. We come to the plays after that then. But you, Tamil and Telugu films also?
No, just one. Just last year, I made my Tamil Telugu debut in a film called Kadan and Aranya, the respective languages, that was the name. But it was trilingual. So in Hindi, it was called Hathi Mere Sathi, and Rana Raghupati was.
We already had that in the 80s, 70s.
Huh, but that has nothing to do with that film. I think they just wanted to go with a relatable title. So during the promotions of the film,
phrase.
Yeah, but we spent half our time telling the press that no, it has nothing to do with that. Because everyone would ask us, so kya wo Rajesh Khanna ji ki Hathi Mere Sathi ka ye remake hai?
Only people of my age and above, don't worry. There's enough people who have no
everybody
idea.
Everybody would just ask us that.
But you dubbed in three languages?
No, I did not dub because I wasn't equipped to dub and I didn't want to sound foolish.
Heavy dialogue. Yeah.
It wasn't, I mean, not even heavy dialogue, but I think you needed to sound authentic,
yeah? My friend Shanaz Treasury, who was a VJ and now does these blogs and stuff, she did a film down south and they couldn't, after some time they gave up and she had to just say ABCD with open mouth and whatever lines.
No. So that so
she was like,
I
tried it and actually, you know, can't really make out
people, a lot of people do that, but I had to, I mean, I would never be able to do that. I think I wanted to enjoy speaking the language. So what I would do is the director would give us lines like 10-15 minutes in advance, which was too late, but I would learn the lines and then they would be like, okay, Tamil writers. So the Tamil writer would come. I would sit with him, do the lines, mug them up, know the emotion and then sort of say it. Once in a while, I would take prompting. Okay, Telugu writers, Tamil would go, Telugu
what are you saying?
And then
only in India.
Incredible.
Oh, wow.
Incredible. And mind you, all of this is happening in rainforest in Kerala when there's no network and it's beautiful. So I think this just, because the film was also about elephants and stuff, it all added to the experience of it. But no, there was no ABCD. I didn't speak gibberish. Yeah.
Wow. But listen, there's also something we have to talk about because I've got a time problem, but you shot something yourself in the pandemic on your own. Is that correct?
Yes.
And a whole serial.
Yeah, it was a series and we shot it last year. Shweta Tripathi, Arjun Mathur, Sanjay Kapoor, they were all part of it. And it's called The Gone Game. We did 4 episodes. We were directed on Zoom and it was a thriller. And we started off not knowing how it's going to be because, you know, the director would be on Zoom. We did our own hair, makeup, styling. We did all readings online first. Very, very interesting script. And the way they designed the show was such that we could do it here. So we did like tutorials on Filmic Pro. We sorted all that out. It was super hectic, but so rewarding because that show did really, really well. And now we have a season 2 coming up where we're shooting normally, of course.
What
but,
have you done, Shreya?
Yeah.
Now producers will know they can save money. No hair and makeup, nothing.
No, they cameras, can't because that was only once, Cyrus. Cannot do that again because it was too hectic. It
but
was
season
too
2.
Hectic.
This season 2.
No, we did now. Season 2 outside, we got our team, but it's
okay,
not
okay, season 2 is conventional. Season 2 is conventional.
Yeah.
Please,
absolutely.
You're killing the market. We'll have no work. They'll tell you, sit at home and shoot yourself. Just shave. That's it.
People have already started telling us to sort of shoot at home. But it's obviously that was just for the time being. But at least we had some sense of doing something, being part of some process during the lockdown when it was generally feeling tough and, you know, just it felt nice to be artistically involved in something at that point. So that was fun.
Okay, listen, we are running out of time. We have to take a break and bring in Silvery. There are a lot of people who want to talk to you on the chat as well. So we'll do that right now.
Hello, everybody. Welcome to another week on the IBM Podcast Network. If you're not following us on social media, please do. We're IBM Podcast on Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram. We'd like to thank the sponsors on the network this week, Seat and Cred. We really appreciate the support. It is what makes this possible. So it was a fun week on Cyrus Says. We had guests like Dolly Singh, we had Guneet Monga, we had Kamya Jani of Curry Tales, and Cock and Bull, as we always did. Do check it out. I think you'll really, really enjoy that. On Paisa Vaisa, we crossed 300 episodes, and Anupam was joined by Akhil Handa, the digital head of Bank of Baroda. All things policy discussed topics like the 100 years of China's Communist Party, the Facebook versus the Government of India case, and the evolution of Indian science. On the Wire Talk, Siddharth Bhatia was joined by Gautam Bhatia to discuss the Central Vista project and why it's attracting so much flack. Sadaf and Archit are back on the Naan Curry podcast, and this time they raise the temperatures as they discuss the beloved spice mirchi. On the Millennial Athlete, this week Tanvi and Shlok speak to Sarita Chauri, a visually impaired judoist. And finally, I want to ask you all to give a listen to the Triangle Offense. Anybody who has heard me talk on a podcast knows I can't shut up about basketball, and these guys know more about it than I do. So if you enjoy basketball, do check this out. Nishant and Monish do an excellent job with this show. I was one of their guests a few months ago, which is how I met them and tried to convince them to come onto the network, and they're finally here. So definitely do check this out. Show's available on all major podcasting platforms, but they also have a daily YouTube episode, which is available on the IBM Podcast channel. And with that, let me get you back to your show.
Follow me at Instagram and Twitter on Bored Brocha. I'm so bored, I need your help. I need your love. I need your touch. Okay, just follow me.
Here comes our producer, Silvery. Very mature young man of 14, with a very long beard. He was a hairy child. You haven't seen the backside. And I don't mean the backside. I mean, as we say in the north of India, backside of the building. Sarji, say hello to Shreya.
Yes, hi. Hi, good morning, Shreya. Hi. How are you doing? Good morning.
Good.
And unfortunately, I haven't been able to go through everything. I want to talk to her about her plays, which you intersperse in the middle. Can I just ask her one thing? So you still, Shreya, you've got the theatre bug also. So are you going to continue doing plays when you go back to normal things after lockdown and you're shooting and all that? Is that something you do like you would continue doing your parents?
You know, the directors who I've worked with are giving me a lot of flack because unfortunately in the last 2 years, I haven't been able to do as much of theatre because, well, fortunately, there's been sort of CDs work and sort of film work that's happening. So I've not been able to commit to it. But whenever I get the opportunity, I give that date and I make sure I do it because you can't compare the joy of being on stage. It's just a different experience altogether. So I would love to. One of my very popular plays, Internal Affairs, is going to be completing 100 shows. You know, we just have 10 shows left now. So I really want to sort of get that
Internal Affairs 100 shows. When is the 100 show? Let's advertise it.
We don't know.
That's not looking good, no? You think they'll open theatres by November, December at least?
I have no idea, but we also did online plays during the lockdown where we were performing online, like virtual theatre. Yeah, so that also, it's not the same, but one can just hope.
My friend Kunal Vijaykar was trying to open a play where he's a belly dancer. You know, a pole dancer, one of those. Yeah.
Wow. And can you call me for the first show for this? I'd love to.
There will be only one show. I've seen the rehearsal.
Would like the VIP tickets, please.
100%. We'll call all three of you. It'll be a great honor.
And I think my parents would like to sit at home for this one.
No. Test of the great Sachin and Supriya's acting prowess. Just keep a straight face. Well, Kunal is dancing to a pole. Okay. Let's get into the... What should we get into? Have you got some comments you want to go into or you want to go into the AMAs first?
I have a question of my own. Shreya, that your father is such a prolific actor, director. Have you also thought about directing at some point?
Absolutely. I would love to direct. I have directed short films and like two short films and a documentary. And it's something that I very much see myself doing. But I'm really, really focused on my acting career. But my antenna is always like right up when it comes to learning about the process. So I edit as well. So I'm constantly sort of figuring that out or, you know, trying to understand production. So I am a student when I'm on set in that sense. So yes, I would love to direct at some point.
Is there a certain genre that you prefer, say acting or maybe even directing in?
Well, I'll speak of acting right now. Something that I haven't done, which I think I'd really like to do is I haven't done an out and out crazy masala Hindi film. I haven't done that.
Is fan then?
Just like where you get like to do the quintessence, and not a houseful, sorry, maybe not a houseful, but like just, you know, where there is
demands,
song,
too many demands.
When there is like song, dance. I mean, I like all genres, but see, like in Mirzapur, it was sort of the hinterland. It was sort of it was a thriller in that sense. So I'd like to do like a nice romantic comedy, you know, or a good biopic.
Opposite whom?
Oh, I have a list.
Bolo, 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 beta.
I don't want to share that list. I don't want to
share that list. And don't tell me Shah Rukh and Salman. Tell me like this generation.
I'd love to work with Vicky Kaushal. He's brilliant.
Yeah.
Vicky Kaushal, for sure. Yeah.
He's still not on our list for the podcast. We haven't decided.
Ranveer. So good.
Ranveer. That's damn confusing. You have them both together, no? And they keep asking the wrong question.
Just imagine.
Ranveer. Sorry, I can't remember. Okay. All right. And post-lockdown, is there anything that you're working on immediately? Or you have to wait and see what happens now?
No, it's like now everything that was sort of waiting, they were just waiting for the floodgates have opened, right?
Also, the rules and regulations are not clear yet.
Yeah, but I mean, thankfully, work will begin, but we have to be careful. I get tested every 3 days, even before sort of this second phase. That's how it was. So I'm doing a legal drama. Since you said lawyer, that is what I'm doing. And there's another series that's not been announced yet, but I can't tell you anything about it. But let's just say that I'm a butcher in it.
Kasai?
That's all I can say.
Ooh, what is that famous butcher Hollywood film?
No, nothing to do with
serial killer?
Do you mean a serial killer?
No, nothing.
What kind of movie am I? I'm going to watch this woman cutting meat. I mean, this is worse than my belly dancer. Make your parents watch both. This is not fair. Okay, this sounds really interesting. We'll hopefully, once the world opens up, we'll get to hear from you again about all this.
Yes.
But in the meantime, what do we have, Mr. Silvery?
So the first couple of comments we have about Tutu Meme. The commenter and Gayatri Ravi have both said basically the same thing. They've said, please convey to your parents that I was a big fan of Tutu Meme. This is said by Gayatri Ravi. She says, can we expect a sequel of the same from your family on OTT platforms? That would be very interesting.
Oh, wow. I haven't thought of that, but I think the iconic Reema Lagu, who we all miss, she's no more.
Right,
yes. Reema Maushi and mom, I think that pair, that chemistry was so iconic. I feel like you can't recreate that, you know.
Correct. Let me ask you this. You know that Friends reunion everyone talked about, even Seinfeld and the reunion. That, if you think the iconic Indian shows also years later, do you think, because that was then and that was, it's got that romance about it. And I saw the Friends reunion, everybody else seems to have liked it, but I found it quite irritating after some time.
No, don't say that. Don't be that person who wants to hate on things that people love. No. You are that person. Come on. It was just so, I mean, it's been part
and
better
for 20 minutes, she sounds like my wife. It's unbelievable already finding the criticisms and, you know, there's no hope, man. Tutu Meme, that kind of, you know, can you really revive it again? I mean, it's how will you reach the same standard, chemistry, romance of that time?
Exactly. It's not needed, especially for certain things. It's best you give the memory of, you keep that memory alive and you keep people sort of reliving that instead of giving them something half-baked. So I don't think Tutu Meme is something that should or can come in that category.
One of the great crimes of India after the Ranga Billa murders in the north was the Ramgarh Ki Shole, if you remember. You know, and
that was iconic for different reasons, yes.
But you don't touch these things. You just don't touch them.
Yeah.
Anyway, that's our point. It doesn't have to be followed. Bolo, Silvery ji.
All right. Next one comes in from Nikita. She says, a big fan of your acting, Shreya. Who is your favorite Indian comedian?
It's a tough one.
You know, this is one of the things that I'll remember this answer much later.
Okay.
Because there are so many people coming.
I'll tell you, I'll put
Ashok
Sharaf right there. I'm not telling you to pay the variety card
here. I'm thinking of the younger ones.
No, nobody. But no, fair enough. Okay. Because, are you talking about the stand-up comedians?
Oh, I thought that's
what the question is. I think that's what the question
okay.
is.
Okay. Then stay there. I thought you were talking about actors. Huh.
Oh.
Actually, it could be either
way. Stay with stand-up. Because yeah. I've confused the issue. Mostly, they'll probably, I don't know, she's used the word acting.
Listen, every time this one-word answer pressure comes, I freeze. Because I can't give one-word answers. I'll never win the handball.
And then later on, you say, oh God, why did I say this? That's the worst feeling in the world.
Yeah. You know what? I don't know why, but I can't pinpoint one person as being favorite, but one bit that I really enjoy, and I think you were on that segment, but Kani's doing the weather.
We auditioned her with that back in 2006. Yeah.
So good. I just remember that. So I got the palm,
peace or punch. That one, yeah.
There are so many good ones out there. Khan, I really don't know how to pick one. Sorry.
Silvery is also a stand-up comedian, huh? So watch out for him. He's young and stuck in lockdown. But do you listen to all these young guys out there? Do you get into this Indian comedians and all that and some controversies? That, I'm not going to ask you the controversies, don't worry. But do you follow them or are you too steeped in all the different things that you're doing and the world around you?
No, I'm not. In the sense, I don't specifically follow just a few, say, thoroughly. But I enjoy watching stand-up comedy and a lot of them, it's so interesting to see how, they speak about relevant issues through their comedy. So from a writing perspective, it's so nice to see how that's evolved, yet it's funny. So I enjoy watching it, but I haven't gone to too many live gigs. Maybe just one. That's really sad. But
whose live gig did you go to?
I don't even remember if I can say that.
Obviously didn't leave a mark. God,
No. I have a problem, really. I'm sorry. I don't even remember clearly right now because there are 2-3 I've been to. But I maybe
it was a musical night and you just found it funny. Sometimes these things go wrong. It happens to a lot of us.
That's so embarrassing, yeah. I don't remember who it was. Sorry.
But the good thing is that you don't remember, so we're safe. If you sort of remembered, it would have been a problem.
Please don't remember.
Because that's really insulting.
I'll have to remember. But
it's a well-known comic. You'll be shattered.
It was someone just starting off, to be honest. It wasn't someone well-known.
And now he's gone back to State Bank of India because it's not working out. You walked out halfway.
I'm so embarrassed. Sorry.
No, would you like to do that? I mean, as a challenge?
It would be scary. That is something that I would be... That's like hats off to these guys who do it. You know, I don't know if I could do that.
Oh, you come from such an accomplished family.
But that is completely different. Stand-up comedy is different.
You mean writing your thoughts and getting your point across? Performing part can't be a problem.
No, to the delivery for it to be comfortable, to seem like it's being, to go from one to another, to engage the audience and then to come back, to just add something. All of that, it has to be seamless and cool and chill. Yet, there's so much preparation. So that itself...
Male belly dancing is the future. You don't have to memorize anything. He has to just rub himself against the pole wearing very little.
Oh, okay.
There are lobbies.
Cyrus fantasies. Oh, God.
Fantasy. I don't have any memory left for fantasy. You can't remember the comedian. Oh, all right. Okay, Silvery, next. Okay.
Yeah, next one. Next one comes in from Akriti Arora. She asks, what is the dining table discussion in the Pilgaonkar family like? Is it more about movies, actors, or anything but cinema?
People think you're not normal people. You know, you only talk about movies and frames. And
a lot of it is actually, so Dad and I are complete foodies. So when we're having one meal, we're discussing the next meal. It's one of those things. So we love, and it's really sad, but we as a family don't end up eating together a lot. Of course, during lockdown, we've been able to, but otherwise, it's all separate timings or whatever. But when we do, it's just catching up, and half the time, our energy is on our dog because he's around and he is wanting food from all our plates.
Yeah. Only food and dog. What happened to the artist? The artists have left the room.
So there are no big life-changing conversations on the dining table. It's very chill. My mom is usually pointing out things that I haven't done or, during the day, and then Dad is sort of pacifying the situation. Jack is pawing everybody to get scraps. So it's.
Silvery, Jack kutta hoga. Don't start googling who's Jack.
Okay.
We could ask the Jacko. Question: Who's the significant? Oh god, that sounds horrible. Jacko.
Jacko.
You, Jacko. Where's Jack? Can we see him?
I've locked him outside because otherwise he would just be... No. I mean, he's outside in the living room. He would be right here, and you guys pressurized me so much with the sound that I kept my
dog first, sound next. What are you saying? Rishi, get on the show. What the hell are you doing? Unbelievable. It's a visual program now. We need the dog to save us.
I'll get him towards the end.
Okay, now that you mentioned food, what is the favorite dish? Horrible question, but whatever comes to mind.
As in, give me a cuisine, as in like what?
Because even Maharashtrian food is so different in different parts of the state. Are y'all a fish family?
Love seafood. Love seafood. So our seafood is slightly Goan because I'm Goan from that side, right? So we don't speak Konkani or anything, but so lots of coconut seafood, fried fish, lots of sabjis. Like at home is that. Thrice a week we have seafood at home. But otherwise thrice a week.
And they call it a Garib Desh. They have lobster thrice a week, Mr. Silvery.
Not lobster. Lobster, it seems. Lobster.
Jinga ko color karke, just draw a mustache or whatever. Lobster.
Mustache.
Talk like that. No, we're against killing of animals. Let's move on. Next question. I'm feeling bad immediately. Silvery, save us with a vegetarian question.
Okay. There's no vegetarian question, sadly. The next question, there are three rapid fire like kind of comments / questions from Sid DA. Sid DA firstly says, congratulations on the success of the film Sita, all set to play at Cannes.
Thank you.
We didn't even mention it. He should have been the anchor.
How sweet. Thank you.
Relevant questions. It was playing at Cannes. How come we didn't know this? It's not in the biodata,
Could you please tell us a little bit more about the film?
Sita is actually one of the first one of the first things that I shot last year once the lockdown was relatively eased. And it's about this young boy who discovers a baby girl who's been abandoned. And, you know, not she's...
controversial, but young boy is not called Sita, right?
No.
Going on?
No. And he wants to bury her. But because he is of lower caste, he is not allowed to give her a certain cremation. And then his struggle to understand what to do with her. And then he ends up meeting my character. She's a mysterious woman. You don't know who she is. And then they have a conversation. And the film is essentially about his interaction with different characters. And then towards the end, I come in. And you don't know who Sita is. Sita is symbolic for many things because you'll have to watch the film to understand that. You can't really explain this, but it's a beautiful shot.
The Magnificent Seven, 1960, has the same premise in the beginning, where Yul Brynner's character is the only one who's willing to bury the Native American guy who's been killed by some terrible white settler. And then he drives the wagon into the burial site. And of course, he has to fight against racist people who are trying to whatever. I don't know why it came to my head, but his reference context is not completely incorrect. It's my favorite film. So you're going to win? Are you going to go?
No, it's not in competition. It's not in competition. It's just in a short film, court metrage. I think that's what it's called. It's in a short film section. And I think 6 films from India were selected. So this was one of them. So it's being screened over there.
There's some French karma in your life, it looks like. Right in the beginning, you started with
tell you, I love the language. And although I'm not fluent or anything, but I studied French. And I just think it's such a sexy language. You can say anything in French and it sounds beautiful.
Like breaking up will be better in French. You know, how would you break up? How do you say like bye-bye to the gay guy or whatever?
Au revoir.
Thanks. That sounds lovely.
It sounds like a breakup.
I love you in English.
sounds like a flying kiss.
And all that is a little bit too much. No? This is better. Both ways. Yeah. So both love and being unloved in French we accept as a higher battle. Do we have time for one more, young man?
Yes. Sure. Yeah, we have we'll complete the two more from Sid DA, if that's fine. CDA, the next one is, since we already talked about it, he says, Shreya, what's the best part of the Friends reunion?
Man, firstly discovering that David Schwimmer and Jen Aniston had a crush on each other.
Yes.
Oh my God, the world didn't know. I'm rooting for them. I'm waiting for that news article where they say that Jen and Schwimmer, and then they give them some hashtag, like, what can it be called? What is like a Jennifer Aniston and David Schwimmer hashtag? But I thought that was so...
But they spent the first few seasons kissing each other on screen. Couldn't they just,
No, but see, that was a special moment. I think the fact that there was actually something there now makes it even more special, because when you go back, the chemistry was unreal anyway. But man, that would be so cool to just have them together. So totally rooting for that. That was my favorite.
Shreya, did you grow up with Friends? Was that one of the shows of your generation sort of thing?
Isn't it obvious? I love
it. You know a lot about details and all. If somebody asked you the...
Oh, yes. I think
about plot lines and all that, you'd know.
Yeah. Like when I'm watching the show, sometimes I know the next dialogue. I can hear it.
Yeah.
Like Silvery grew up on Bob the Builder, which is also quite iconic.
I know and Bob the Builder.
And Friends. And Friends. I love Friends.
Bob the Builder, you still watch, no? Silvery?
Huh? Yeah, why not? Also, Thomas the engine.
Tank thing. Engine.
Pingu.
Yes, who remembers.
All that.
All right. Chalo.
Last one from Sid DA is, Shreya, how was it meeting Ruskin Bond, childhood hero of our times?
This person's very sweet. It's really following my travels.
Sometimes it's a little scary that they know so much.
I mean, I obviously have shared these things before, but quick short story is that in school, in the 10th grade, I entered this competition. It was like an ITC Young Authors competition where I had to write a story, and the title that was given to us, that I picked from the different titles, was called An Appointment with God. And my story was shortlisted, and 10 stories from India were shortlisted to be published in a book edited by Ruskin Bond. And during the felicitation ceremony, he did not end up coming, and that broke my heart because I really wanted to meet him.
Broke his bond?
Yes, our bond temporarily at that point somewhere broke. But cut to when I eventually started acting, I was in Delhi, and one of the Ruskin Bond plays was adapted by A.K. Verrius, and Akash said that, you know, he knows them, they're in Landore in Mussoorie, and I love to travel, I love the mountains. So I basically went there to meet him for the first time, and I spoke to him, and I got my book signed. And then eventually I keep going back. I love Landore. I love that place. So I keep going there and I meet him every time. So I love his writing because it's so simple. It just warms your heart. So I'm a fan of Ruskin Bond.
And did he say the iconic words when you met him for the first time? My name is Bond.
Ruskin Bond.
No, because do you think he's going to be that cliche? Do you think Ruskin Bond is going to be cliche? He's not going to appreciate the cliche.
I'm going to take a beating. I'm going to self-flagellate myself, because this is like Cyrus the Virus. Everybody's got something which is obvious with their name and whatever. And then all their life, can you imagine, every secondhand comedian has made that comment. So can you imagine 50 years on, if someone is still saying that, how irritating.
Nobody say it. Only you are saying it.
You just have to have a low brow, low mindset. Yeah, it'll happen. Silvery loved it. He was also thinking it didn't have the guts. Right, Silvery?
I actually was thinking it, but yeah. Yes.
Yeah.
There's one more. Sorry. So sorry. There's one more question from Kashin Shetty. He says, hi, Shreya. I think you and Kashin know each other. So because he says, remember that show of the government inspector back in 2015 where I snapped at you on stage? Have you forgiven me for that? Also, any future aspirations for directing? The second party of all
Is that true? Is that true?
What? Off character? Kashin, he did not know. I mean, in character, he had to do that. But Kashin is amazing. Hi, Kashin. Fantastic actor. I love him. Kashin, you're forgiven. Anything that you do is like, you're just forgiven. You're awesome. And future aspirations for directing, I think I just said that. I want to act a lot more. I want to learn a lot more. And yes, I think we have some great role models of actors who are also successfully directing now. So, you know, acting and producing and directing. So it's a good time to try and be ambitious and do those things. If you can do
that. What about having a family and stuff?
Who says I have to pick? I can do all of it, na?
And is there any thing you'd like to share with us?
No, there is nothing to share in that department. Unfortunately.
I think she's acting. Silvery, I think she's a very good actress. What do you think?
There's nothing to share in that department, I swear. No one's even called me in this 1 hour that we've been talking. See?
What are you saying? They're all these people are your fans and they're all males. I think there was one female, the rest of them are all males. Yeah. Anyway, we'll leave that for now.
Great question to end on. It is a very short question to end on. Trevor Fernandez asks, favorite restaurant in Bombay, guys?
Oh, as of now, it's La Loca Maria in Bandra. It's amazing. They have the best tacos there. La Loca Maria. Yes, in Bandra. It's a tiny restaurant. Fantastic food. I'm obsessed with that place. It's Spanish cuisine.
Oh, I thought it was a bunch of Bengali men called tapas walking around. But obviously not.
Crickets. I just heard crickets. Cyrus, I'm still a fan. Huh? I'm still a fan.
Maybe not once the podcast is over.
So La Loca Maria, you guys, genuinely, no jokes. Just call me later. I'll tell you what to order. Too good.
I mean, now that's it's open for lunch. It may be open because they're allowed. 14, they'll open for dinner as long as the numbers don't go up. They will allow
but
them.
They were also doing delivery otherwise.
Shreya, it's not fun.
I'm telling you, I'm such an emotional eater. So the days that I wasn't even feeling very good, I would still make sure I order. Then I'll book like a delivery person to go pick it up. I'll go through all that tamjham just because that food comforts me so much. I mean, I'm genuinely an emotional eater. I will do anything for food. Once I travel for 2 hours to eat something that I really liked, I don't want to tell you what it is, then you'll say,
it's got to be something funny. Come on, tell us, please.
It was this dhaba where they make amazing butter chicken.
That's great. That's awesome.
This is in the north side?
Nahi. Yaha. Towards
Pune. On
a highway? Yeah. I don't remember because this is someone near Talegaon. A friend of mine used to study there, so he had taken
us. It's got a Punjabi name only, yaar. It's a small little dhaba,
I don't remember. But an aspiration of mine in life is also to have like my own travel show where I just go and eat different things and I talk about it. It's something I really want to do.
Travel show and lockdown. You've chosen the most difficult thing right now to get into. And you need to act again, but your travel show just hang in there.
I know. Hopefully,
food will come
somewhere.
Home.
Yeah.
Cyrus, what about your favorite restaurant in Mumbai?
I want to go now, but Aisha is not carrying money, man. They won't
ask
free.
Me, what's your favorite restaurant in Mumbai?
I'm a South Bombay boy, so I'm outside Colaba. I'm just a foot of it. So all the restaurants there, they haven't made money for 2 months. All are regulars.
So
Olympia,
what do you like? Which one do you like?
I like everything. Delhi Darbar, Jafar Bhai, Paradise, which is closed now. Churchill.
What is your opinion of Parsi food in Bombay? Like which place? Don't say Britannia, except Britannia.
Britannia, but there's Jimmy Boy, which is right next to
I've
us.
I had Jimmy Boy. Yeah.
So that's not bad. And Ideal Cafe is my absolute all-time greatest ever. Parvez is he's a bike
Ideal
lover.
Cafe.
If you're a bike lover, he won't charge you. Yeah. Go on a fancy bike, you'll be treated like, oh, it's a small little place just here, just near the Reserve Bank. But super food. And they have a menu, like fixed Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday. And they have a one thing that you get every day.
I attended my friend Dilshad, her nephew is there, Navjot. The food, Cyrus, the food. Oh my God.
And not only that, when you're full, more food is coming and you're like, there's no space left if you don't have experience. Because the chawal, that comes later. The palau, which is, So a lot of people foolishly eat so much because there's like so many things before that. Even the Lagnu Kasat sometimes is served up front and you're full. Wow. And then you see all this extra stuff coming.
Yeah. So please invite me next time for something.
Where? They can't even have lagans. A friend of mine was having one in March just when the damn thing started. And they lost a lot of money also.
If at all you feel like if you all are going to do something at home, just I'm someone. If you invite me, I will show up. So genuinely. So
really?
Just
wow. Yeah, if those you are my only friends. Those are my only friends. You know, the desperate ones who just come. Whatever.
For food, I'm telling you, I'm shameless when it comes to food. If you in passing also say, I will like text and say, hey, you were going to make. And like make some nice Parsi food and call me.
But you all have between Bandra and Andheri, you have much more choice than we have. It's not
100%. 100%.
I'm just got 5 or 6 places here nearby and then nothing. Manin Drive is what? Nothing. And Valkeshwar.
That's true.
That's it.
That's true.
So, you know, you're spoiled for choice. But now I'm feeling hungry. Thanks. It's only 11 o'clock. And I hope they're open. Actually, we'll go and find out now. It's so nice. There'll be nobody there. Shreya, this is the best time to go yourself. The whole restaurant is empty. The poor guys are trying to restart.
That's so you true. Go? We should. No, at some point.
Yeah, go. We'll stop. We'll stop. Otherwise, we'll keep talking. I'm like one of those, New York housewives. Just go on and on for no reason.
No, go from here. I thought you said go to the restaurant. No,
I can't go to 12. It'll be really desperate of me, when people are like, I'm going and this and that. And I'm standing like a fat samosa saying, Abhi khula hai? Abhi khula hai? That poor guy. Anyway, chalo. Listen, it's been wonderful talking to you. Great respect for your family. Wonderful.
Thanks,
absolutely top draw. And let's hope that you go from here strength to strength and we get to hear from you once this lockdown is over as well. And personal stories. Yeah, Silvi, do some keda on that. Yeah. And we let her go this time. But now we have a friendship. So second time we can be a little bit more informal.
Done.
Okay. Bye,
thank
everybody.
You, Cyrus.
Thank you so much.
Take care. Bye. Thanks, guys. Bye.
Okay, catch us on any of the podcasting apps, please. We beg you, we need you. Send us your questions on Twitter on Cyrus Says In, or you can email us, even if you're not female, on whatcyrussays@gmail.com.
If you love cricket, listen up. The Edges and Sledges Cricket Podcast is here for you. Hosted by DJ, Varun, and me, Ashwin, we bring a fun, fresh, fans' point of view to talking all things cricket. Sometimes it's just the three of us, sometimes we have guests, including current and former international cricketers. For new episodes every week, check out the Edges and Sledges Cricket Podcast on the IVM app, website, or wherever you get your podcasts.
Hi, I am Sadaf.
And I'm Arshad. Khane ka itihas, economics, policy, psychology, sab hai menu pe.
Only on the Naan Kali podcast. Every Wednesday, sirf IVM podcast app ya website par. Ya fir jahan se bhi aap apne podcast sunte ho.